love the Claude Code workflow, hate the cost? I'll show you how to install GLM 4.6 inside of Claude Code with equal, near, or above Claude Code performance at a fraction of the cost. Hello, I'm Jeremy Grove, founder of Metadata Fusion. In this video, I will walk you through setting up GLM 4.6 inside of Claude Code and Kilo Code for optional hybrid fallback and a fast global install so every terminal and IDE works the same. So GLM is from Z.ai. They've been around for a while. Their previous version was GLM 4.5, which actually had quite a few positive reviews from a lot of different developers. And the cost to performance ratio is just really, really good. You'll see here they're offering half off on the first month. So $3 for the first month and $6 a month after. And this is significant. I think each one of these is like, this is the equivalent of Anthropic Claude Code. This would be like their pro plan, and this would be their $100 max plan, and this would be their $200 max plan. And each one of these outperforms those. You know, with the rate that AI is going, it's changing a lot. So it may be kind of risky to pay for, you know, a whole year in advance. But to think about that, if you pay for a whole year in advance, $360 for a whole year of this max plan, which I believe this max plan, if we go down to the FAQ down here, the max plan is 3 times the usage quota of the $200 Claude max plan. I mean, that honestly, that's just insane value. Really a lot of value there. But I'm debating on doing that myself. I'm gonna continue testing it. I've actually been quite impressed with the performance. In actually some areas, I'm ranking this above Claude Code. In some areas it's equal, and then maybe it's slightly under. But the value for the money, it's just insane. I think a lot of people might really, really benefit from using this, especially starting off a project, getting it set up. Maybe they would need Claude Code or Codex potentially as a second option. You need always need one option, in my opinion, as a developer. In these times, we need to be nimble. We need to have more than one plan. So you can look at the pricing here. It's quite decent here. Really, really great value. I've been very happy with it. I've been using inside of Claude Code I've been testing this for about a week now. And it's really nice because I do really like the Claude Code workflow. I've been using Codex a lot as well, but there is something about the Claude Code interface. I've been using it for so long. It's really nice. And you can use this really well inside of Claude Code. So if you decide to get one of these plans, you're gonna basically subscribe to it. And then you're gonna need to get your API keys. I would delete these codes afterwards. But basically, once you get your API keys, you're gonna need those to set up your interface. So you can see ZI has guides. They have guides for all these. They have a guide for a Claude Code. And they give you a basic install guide. What I'm going to propose as a free option that you can download from my website, a more complex guide that's going to give you different types of interface. And then I'll probably have a part two to that guide, because currently they don't support inside of Claude Code switching models. But there is a way that you can configure that. But I'm going to walk you through getting Claude Code set up. And I'm going to assume that most everyone has Claude Code installed already. So you can install this inside of Claude Code, Cline. Cline has not been doing a lot. They're a little disappointing. as they have not been doing a lot of updates. Open code, kilo code. So I will go ahead and show you kilo code. I think kilo code has been doing pretty well of late. And I think it's good to have a fallback in case the Claude Code interface is having issues. But I do think the Claude Code interface works a little bit better. It's just a little cleaner and you can use it directly through the terminal instead of the IDE. So this is a guide that I've put together that'll be free for anybody that wants to get it. You would just go over to meetatdatafusion.com, go to guides, and you can download this. It's a PDF that I've put together. It's got a more detailed install guide depending on whether you're on Mac. I'm on Mac, whether you're on Windows, Linux, etc. So it'll give you a more detailed guide on how to install this quickly. And my recommendations would be to install this globally. You can install this to your repos directly. So say you wanted to have this installed on one repo and not another, but then that would require putting your ENV instead of a JSON file inside your project folder. But I would recommend going with the global route. So this guide will be available for free download at meetatdatafusion.com. It'll give you a detailed guide on all the different options. So to start this off, I'm assuming most of you already have Claude Code installed. But if you don't, this is what we're gonna need to do first. So we're gonna copy and paste that. So for those who already have Claude Code installed, like myself, we wanna make sure that we have the latest version of Claude Code installed. So instead of the previous command that I showed you, so if you don't have Claude Code, you'll need to run the one that I showed you on the guide. This will be the second one, is if you already have it, to update it to make sure you have the latest version. So this is going to be the relevant command for mine to update it. So I'll pop that in there. I want to update it, make sure that I'm on the latest version. So it's going to ask for your password. So that's going to be the password of your machine. I'm on Mac. So we just want to make sure that we're on the latest version. All right, looks like we're all good to go. So now we're going to install the package for the GLM. So in the guide, which I will show you, if you're on Mac, such as myself, you're going to use this key here. So you're going to install your API key right here. You're going to get that from Z.ai when you create an account. It's actually very simple. You can just sign in with Google, or you can sign in with one of the other platforms or your email. And by default, it's got the GLM 4.6. Probably in a later video, if there are people wanting to see it, I will show you how you can set up a switcher. Because currently inside of Claude Code, you would have to do some extra configuring to be able to easily switch back. But there's a way that you can configure this through your terminal to easily switch back and forth between the different models. But yeah, you're going to add basically your key here, and you're going to paste this basically directly into terminal. So you'll see I've got all my commands there. I'm gonna greet this. So now that we've got that installed, now we're gonna want to navigate to the repo that we want to do. So I'm gonna go to this project here. I've got this project already locally. And you can see that I'm already on the dev branch. And let's run Claude. And you'll see that we're already in here. Okay, so you can configure this just like you would do on any of the other Claude versions with Anthropic. And you can see we're on the latest model. And that's one of the key elements that I would like to stress. I'm not sure if for those of you that have this already installed, make sure that you run that update as I suggested so you can have the latest version. I'm going to keep them in dark mode. And you can see the GLM 4.6 API usage billing. So literally, it's just as simple as that. I mean, this thing is literally going to, it runs all the same functions. You got the plan mode, which that's one of the things that I really like about plan mode. It's really nice. It's got all the agents. And it's literally going to work the same. So this is working directly through terminal, which I feel is slightly faster. I don't know. I think it's maybe a 5 to, it could be a 10%, depending on the size of the code base. I think it's a slight advantage, depending on your workflow. But I've installed this globally. So I can literally run this either way. Let's just try out a simple command. Just to see it, a nice little typo, but it's pretty snappy. The value for money of GLM 4.6, it's pretty nice. So it's giving us the whole analysis. So okay, we got all the same functions. No, we'll just keep planning. So it just gave me the status. And the project that it's referring to is this one. So I can literally open up the same Claude code. Let's see if actually this extension is going to work. Yeah, same. GLM 4.6 right there. So I can work through the terminal directly, as you see me just doing, or I can come on over here to the IDE. So next, I will show you how to have a backup. Or a primary. You know, some of you may prefer Kilo Code. Kilo Code is actually quite nice. And I will show you that now. So for Kilo Code, I would definitely recommend going to their website. Kilocode.ai. Definitely recommend going over there to their website. Just like I've recommended in some of my past videos, if you have an option for any cursor extension, if you have an option to install it directly from the provider's website, it's much safer to do it from their website. And Kilo Code is giving you that option, which is great, because that's, as I've explained in my previous videos, there's a lot of clones, specifically in the Cursor App Store, and it also happens even in the VS Code App Store, but it's a little safer. But if you have an option to do that, this is the way you'd want to do it. So we're just going to hit that, and we're going to open it directly in the Cursor App Store. Boom. That simple. And you know it's from Kilo Code. It's not a clone, because there's clones that you got to be careful. So we're going to go ahead and install it. Yes, we do entrust. All right, we're going to use our own API key. Okay, let's get this off the side. So we're not going to use Kilo Code. We're going to use Z.ai. Maybe we are. There we go, Z.ai. Okay, now we're going to enter our key. And we're going to use their latest model, GLM 4.6. Let's go. So Kilo Code, somewhat similar to Cursor, but it has a lot of interesting features. You can configure it to do different models. You can use different providers for different tasks, architect mode. It has a lot of features. It's quite nice. We will just put a simple. So you got the architect mode, plan and design, code, ask, debug, orchestrator. This is quite nice, the orchestrator mode. So Kilo Code is quite nice. I hope they continue to develop this. I think this is one of the tools that I will be using quite often going forward if they continue to support it. So let's just put it in architect mode and just give it a test run just to see how we're doing. So let's just give it a run. And those of you who are not familiar with Kilo Code, it has quite a few nice options. And I think in today's landscape that anybody that's a developer, experienced developer, or even a vibe coder or new to vibe coding or using any of these AI tools, it's good to be testing out some of the newer tools and the different AI providers. So this has a lot of, this Kilo Code has a lot of interesting features. They give me our context length, our tokens, quite a few. A lot of interesting things. And as we stated, GLM supports all these other providers, OpenCode, Kilo Code, Root Code, Crush, and other tools. So there's quite a few options. And that's how easy it is to install GLM 4.6 inside of Claude Code and enjoy the Claude Code workflow and agents at a fraction of the cost and an optional Kilo Code fallback. You can get a full expanded guide of this on my website, metadatafusion.com guides. That's all for me. Subscribe, like, and I'll see you in the next one.